Hello all. In this presentation, I'm going to explain about what is transportation engineering. Just we are going with the basics, like what is the transportation engineering and what are the things that engineers, what are the responsibility of the civil engineer in the transportation engineering stream. Okay, so this topic is under introduction to civil engineering in module 1. Okay, so first of all, what is transportation engineering? Like, it is the engineering in the application of technology and many scientific principles to the planning or functional design, operation, management of facilities, whatever the facilities we have, and for any mode of transportation, maybe railways or roadways, airways, waterways. I think we have all these types of means of transportation we have. So it should be in order to provide a safe, efficient, comfortable journey or a convenient to the society, and also economical. Definitely the transport means of transportation is very much essential in everyone's life. So definitely, so it should be affordable to everyone. It should be economic. It should be affordable to each and everyone. I think, for example, I can say the outer ring roads, what we call, or nice roads, what we call. These are all like we have to pay there. We have to pay and we have to travel in that highways, what you call national highways or a few state highways as well. So there we have to pay the tolls and we have to travel. So these are not affordable to everyone. Okay, so the main aim of transportation engineering is to give a proper, safe, the means of transportation which efficient and comfortable for traveling, and with the good quality of all the material should be used to construct that, and also it should be very much convenient and comfortable to the public. So that is one of the main aim of transportation engineering. And the economic, social, commercial and industrial development of the nation, definitely it is all dependent on the transportation facilities what we have, right? And also the sub branches of the transportation engineering are as follows. So for example, the road engineering, highway engineering, railway engineering, harbors, bridges, docks and the harbor engineering, both are same. Docks means dockyard. Dockyard means naval dockyard, which is the harbor, what we call harbor. So only for a harbor place we'll call harbor, but the thing which is starts and all the materials should be all the materials are going to manufacture of all, you know, the ships, manufacture industries where they're located, that area is called as docks. Actually it's called a dockyard. Okay, so next, like transportation is like means of the movement of the people and other goods from one place to another place, like we know. And but what the engineers will do here, that is the main thing. They'll construct the roadway and maintenance, as well as the design, the airports, subways, metro stations, etc. And also sometimes like they work for outdoors for the construction sites to monitor the progress and any other problems that came up with. So most of the time, like work of full time. And also transportation system is backbone of the overall progress of the country. I think we have to agree with each and every human being should travel for many things, maybe for education thing, maybe for a work, or to buy something for hospitals or institutions, many things, like each and everyone should travel. So transportation system is one of the backbone of the everyone, and also it is the overall progress of our country, progress of the any country. Okay, and also it will covers the study and also designing the construction of roads, railways, waterways and airways, along with the bridges, tunnels, stations, harbors, airports, etc. So all the designing things and the construction things, everything will happen in the transportation engineering. In this picture you can see like how the highways are designed. What is the width of the highway? What is the width of the road divider? What is the width of the footpath? So these all rules and regulations is comes under transportation engineering. Okay, so I think national highway and state highways width is same, like 8 meter of the width of the pavement, that is a road, and 2 meter of the road divider or a footpaths. Okay, both the sides. So this is a standard design of national highway and state highway. So this responsibility will be taken care by the state government for a state highway and central government for the national highways. So this is about the roadways, and we'll come into the railways. Here the track should be aligned properly, and also from the point 1 to the point 0, I mean the point, the last point, that rail which is they have constructed, they have installed, should be in the same width. I think we all know. Okay, so the different technologies the engineer should adopt here. So they have to maintain not only construction, even the maintenance of railway lines. That is also one of the important task of civil engineers. They have to take care of this. Not only designing, just maintaining the things. Okay, so this is one of the the duty of a civil engineers, and also airports. In airports, you can see many different parts of the airport will be there. For example, runway is different, and also taxiway is different. In taxiway, what's going to happen? In runway, what's going to happen? How to design that? And also, what is the width of the vehicle? Vehicle means the flight. According to the width of the flight, they have to decide the width of the runway. Right? So according to that, they will fix the standard for a manufacturing of the vehicles, and also they'll fix the standard for a runways, the width of the runways, and also signal system is very important here. Okay, maintenance of the signal system, every often, like, we need to be maintained properly all the signal systems. Okay, so these construction part and the design part and maintenance parts, altogether it will comes under transportation engineering, right? So here also you can see width of the vehicle, and also width of the runway. Same thing in the highways also. I'll just open. Okay, here also, like, there is a standard according to the Indian Road Academy, like, there is a standard width of the vehicle. So everyone should maintain the width of the vehicle. Okay, according to the width of the vehicle, the highways are designed. And also according to the width of the vehicle, if the two vehicles are moving, definitely there should be a gap between both. So that minimum width plus the vehicle width, both the vehicle and the minimum width. Okay, all together they'll sum up and they're deciding the width of the highway. So this is how they're designing the the highways. Actually, we will call the pavement. The pavement surface means the black color, what you call what you are seeing in the picture, that is called, technically it is called a pavement, but we will call a road, that is called a pavement surface. And for the smooth journey, so what should be the materials to used, and how smooth should be it is. And in the crossings, they have to provide a super elevation. Super elevation means in the curves of the road, they will provide a little the height of the curve will be higher compared to the inner surface. I think in the curves of the highway, you can observe this. Okay, how to design that? I think super elevation topic we are going to study in the fifth module. So there in detail I will explain. So super elevation is one of the part of the highway, so that highway and railway both. So the outer part of the road or a railway will be higher compared to the inner, to avoid skidding, to avoid friction, to maintain the same speed of the vehicle. So these are advantages of super elevation. So that is one of the part of the highways. And also this is like maintaining everything, construction everything, designing everything, it's all comes under transportation engineering. Thank you.